if you have a situation where your tag names can potentially change, you might want to use the PointID to tag function. In the PointID to tag function, instead of just using a tag name to drive your reports, you would use the PointID to tag function and select the tag using the tag search dialog box. Search for the tag, select the tag, and you'll notice return is the PointID for the tag. And in the cell that shows the tag name, we do not show the tag name itself. We show the PointID to tag function along with the PointID of the tag. The reason for that is that regardless of how many times you rename a tag in the Py server, the PointID for that tag will never change. The actual index in the system is PointID, not tag name, and that's why you're allowed to change the tag names as often as you wish. However, when you do that, you break things like data link reports. So if you are concerned that your tag names may change in the future and you don't want to redo your reports, then you can use the Py PointID to tag feature. There's a function in data link that was added in version 3 called attribute mask to tag that allows you to maintain a list of tags based on specified variables. And what we mean by that, we'll show you two examples. Let's say we want a list of all of our tag names based on the character B. I've got a B asterisk there indicating a B and a wildcard. And I'll select attribute mask to tag, and the attribute mask I'm going to use is tag name. So I will put that mask into that field and click OK, and you'll see all of the tags that I got with the attribute mask beginning with B. You can also do it for things like point source. I can say the attribute mask to tag using point source of R, and we get a list of that. I can also do a combination. Let's say I want to use a combination of tag name B and point source of 9. I can do that as well by selecting Py attribute mask to tag and selecting for the tag name field the B wildcard and the point source of 9, and that will give me all of the tags that match that combination. So you can use the Py attribute mask to tag to maintain lists of tags based on certain criteria. So if the list ever updates, you can just recalculate the spreadsheet and it will get your new list of items.